TV. Well, celebrity impressionist Jim Meskimen became an internet sensation after posting this little old clip.
That as I am a Christian faithful man, right, I would not spend another such night, though tortured by a world of happy days.
Methought that I'd broken from the tower and was embarked across to Burgundy. And in my company, my brother Gloucester, who from my cabin tempted me to walk upon the hatches. Thence we looked toward England, and conjured up a thousand heavy times during the wars of York and Lancaster that had befallen us.
That is uncanny, and we're very happy to have the man of many voices with us in the studio today. Good morning to you, Jim.
Yeah, good morning, good morning.
It is great to have you here. Yeah. Your George W. Bush is incredible.
Thank you very much.
When did you discover you had this incredible talent?
You know, I was very young, and my first words were, you know, I grew up in the Kennedy era, so my first words were, you know, someday we will put a man on the moon after I get changed. And I do a lot of, I love to change personalities, and audiences love to see a guy suddenly change to someone else. You know, there's something marvelous about that, you know. I think we forget that you can shift viewpoints very quickly.
How do you do that? What's the process like, and how do you slip into that?
It's a very complex process, yeah. Very complex, yeah. And secret. You know, it's a decision. You know, I just kind of go, well, I'm Cary Grant now, and that's the end of the story, you know. I don't need to do any more than just decide. And with a lot of practice, you know, that's how you bring it off. That's how I can do Ricky Gervais as quickly as I did. You know, I have to work up to it. It was nice. That's what I'm going to do in my show tonight, the Sound Lounge at the Seymour Center. I'm going to do about 65 impressions, my whole live show, the Jimpression show. That's what I'm in town
That's
for.
The Seymour cool. Center in Sydney.
In Sydney, exactly. Tonight at 7:30.
That's not bad.
I'm working on it, aren't I? Yeah. Trying to communicate with the locals, yeah.
Well, President That's Obama cool. has just been here trying to do an Aussie accent. What did you
Did he? Did he try to do an Aussie accent?
He tried, yeah.
How did it come off?
Oh, it was pretty bad.
That's a tough one. Obama has a kind of a stilted cadence, so I can't imagine that he did too well at it, but he can surprise you.
A stilted cadence.
Stilted cadence, yeah. Yes. I'll take the stilted, stilted cadence with a little toast. Would be very nice.
They're all so unique, and I guess that's the thing about them that we recognise through mannerisms and also the vocal tone.
Yeah, and it's sort of, it's really a viewpoint thing. You know, you just sort of change your viewpoint. If you're George Clooney, you just have a different way of expressing yourself. Morgan Freeman as well. Everything sounds warm and delightful. Robert De Niro, it's a whole other thing. He can't be too happy about it because, after all, his mouth is upside down. That's funny. Everyone's having a good time. It's nice.
And it's not just about doing the voice. You've also got to come up with words that really reflect the person.
Well, that's what I mean. I mean, it's a bit like with Robin Williams. You just have to suddenly take on his viewpoint and sort of enter his universe. You know, a completely different universe. It's a comedy universe. You know, it's like down here you have the Southern Cross. You're in the Southern Hemisphere. We have the Southern. We have the Southern Cross too up in America, but it's usually on someone's lawn burning. It's just a different viewpoint. That's all.
Oh, we were talking about
hello, Alabama.
Sean Connery.
Yes, you're doing a fine impression of Sean Connery just then. I admired it greatly. For some reason, he's one of those voices that everybody does impressions of. Like Christopher Walken is another one in the States anyway. Everybody does this impression. It's like a disease.
One that not too many people get right though is Woody Allen.
Yeah, which is, you know, it's a pity. You know. Because it's, you know, it's such a wonderful way to be, you know, neurotic. I know you like the impression of Woody Allen. You mentioned that before.
I do.
And I just want to discourage you from, you know, carrying on a relationship with an imitation person. That happens altogether too much in L.A. L.A. is the only place in the world where the word vacuous is a compliment.
Can you slip in? I love Jack Nicholson. I think he's just so angry.
What's not to love about Jack? He seems to enjoy life fully. It's a good lesson for all of us, you know. Of course, these days, he's sort of like the old diplomatic Jack. He's not so fiery anymore. But underneath the surface, you feel like any minute he's going to explode and lose it, you know.
We want to forgive given you that. You
yeah, I almost did. I don't know if I can lift that. I'm a little worried about the fish in this tank.
Yeah.
I'm sure that someone will take care of
them. I think they've been dead for a while.
No, I'm not worried anymore, you see.
You have to keep up with the modern trends as well. The elder statesmen of Hollywood, of course, are around, but the modern ones, who do you pick out? Like, you've got Ricky Gervais, but yeah, how do you pick out the ones you're going to take off? And are some of them harder?
Definitely harder. Also, you know, at my age, doing some of the younger blokes sounds a little strange. So you gotta, you know, leaven it, figure it out, work it, you know. I love being Ricky Gervais.
It's a little bit like David Beckham as well, isn't it?
Is he?
Yeah, probably right.
I dare say you're right. No, but people love to hear the voices that they kind of have in their head, you know, as well, the people that they remember from days gone by, you know.
But the other trick is, though, to get straight into it. Because normally it takes a while to warm up. Mm-hmm. But within half a word, you're there.
Yeah, you just got to make a decision to be there. Sometimes I go, like right now, I went to a guy, I don't even know who this is. Does it matter? I don't know. So early in the morning, I don't know where I'm going.
Can you do the juke?
The Duke?
Yeah.
We call him, oh, the Duke.
Yeah, the Duke, sorry.
Duke. Duke. Yeah. We take the J out of that word for some reason. I don't know why.
You Hollywood people.
John Wayne is still popular. I did a show for a bunch of 8-year-olds and they all knew who John Wayne was. And can I pimp my show again tonight? It's at the Sound Lab, Seymour Center, 7:30 tonight, one night only, before I get on the plane tomorrow.
You even shifted uncomfortably on your horse then as you were doing John Wayne.
I shifted uncomfortably, and I make sure I don't take too many breaths because I've only got that one lung.
Okay, what about Arnie?
Arnold Schwarzenegger, of course, is one of the most impersonated people in the world. Desperately wants to be president of the United States. I don't know why. Is it ever going to happen? I don't think so, you know. But still, I mean, he's been the governor of California now for a long time. And, you know, unfortunately, he's left us a legacy that is nothing we're too happy about.
What do you think W would think of Arnie?
Well, I think W and Arnie get along. They're like peas in a pod. The two of them have a lot to talk about. I mean, like, for example, I'm here in Australia. And as soon as I get back, I'm going to call up Arnie and say, hey, I've been to your hometown. I think he'll be very amusicated by the whole thing.
Oh, we've so missed you, W. We've so missed you here in Australia, on the world stage. Good man.